Hi, in this video we'll show you how to use the new auto-tiling filter in Substance 3D Sampler. This new filter works best with specific images and materials that have a defined and repetitive structure, like woven textures or small patterns which take time to tile manually. It is especially useful for textiles, run fully on device and ensures your image or materials are not sent to the cloud. A minimum of 3 repetitions vertically and horizontally, so 9 repetitions of patterns in total is required for the filter to work. Let's check out how it works in Substance 3D Sampler. First, I use the Fabric Diffuse photo as base. Let's apply the auto-tiling filter to the layer stack. If you import an image to create the material using the image-to-material workflow, you will get better results by applying auto-tiling before the image-to-material filter. Once applied, the filter tries automatically to tile your image or material, and in many cases this default result is already quite good. If the default result does not satisfy you, you can tweak it by going into the advanced settings. This opens a new window with several steps displayed. It's not necessary to go through each step. Go to Precise Later Step by clicking on its name in the top progress bar. This way you can only modify one or a couple and apply them directly via the Apply button on the top right corner. The default downscale option in the sample settings should be good. But it can be useful to have a larger computation sample size when working with small patterns that require higher resolution for proper detection. Image unwarp is really useful to straighten patterns that are not aligned perfectly. The pattern size step is one of the most important and might be the first one to check if the pattern isn't being detected properly. In the pattern detection step, you can move points, which are in an obvious way not placed correctly. Within Region of Interest step, you define the area of the material, which will be used and repeated. The larger the rectangle, the less repetitions will be detected, but you may want to avoid areas with visible artifacts, such as blurriness on the sides of a scan or lighting differences. Tweak the seams in the Seams Removal step. It is possible to preview the pattern repeated to verify the tileability. It is possible to use a photo of a material which has been photographed in far from ideal conditions. Even with a non-perpendicular camera angle or non-uniform lighting, it works mostly really well. If you import a material, material maps or images that have already gone through image-to-material process, the filter will by default use the base color map to detect the pattern and do the auto-tiling. If the pattern is more visible in another channel, for example, the weave is better visible in the height, you have to change the map you want the tiling to be based on in the advanced settings. In this video, we covered the new auto-tiling filter in Substance 3D Sampler, which is awesome to tile images and materials with a defined and repetitive structure. We hope you found this overview helpful and can't wait to see what you will create with it. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more tutorials.